It's time to get ready for loving the people of Islam with all of our hearts, with all of our souls, as we call even upon the new name of Allah, which is no longer a title. The star of stars is shining. If we can but discern the glimmering, shimmering from the crystalline ocean on high, the sapphire sea. Get ready, here we go. It is time, and I am so happy to just be only a messenger. Well, grab your pens and paper now.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
Behold, the arms of the Lord is not too short to say. And guess what? Everybody in Christianity is insane. I was a good Christian. I was a Pharisee. Earl was a viper. I would have said, all of you is going to hell.
That. But you know what? I had
logic come and eat my brain all the garbage that was there, and
Allah reprogram me. So, guess what? Here is the utter truth. There will never be another important prophet ahead of Muhammad. I am the merchant that Islam has been waiting for. 30 years as a credit card marketer, as a duct cleaner job salesman, and as a grocery man for 10 years, door to door. And Muhammad was correct about a lot of things. Praise Allah. He is the true God, and the Christianity God is false as they are. Nothing has been corrupted, though, in the Word of God. Allah promised to preserve remembrance in the Quran, and He has done that. Look at the Dead Sea Scrolls. Not a word of Isaiah has changed. Identical Isaiah as it was 3,000 years ago by the earliest transcript. Now Allah kept His promise in the Dead Sea Scrolls. And praise God that upon the Lord's latter day mountain of Isaiah 2 and Isaiah 25, the Lord God has removed now His rebuke as He promised. Praise God for the true God of Islam, and much more true. And my heart will always be with Islam now, even though I was so deceived. But know this, that He who is the best deceiver had a mystery. Revelation 10:7 said so, the best deceiver of all, and His mystery was hidden in plain sight. I have decoded all of it, connected all of the dots. Judge for yourself. But it raises Islam to the highest heights so that the prophecy of Habakkuk can go forth. I have recorded 17 hours of praise of Allah straight. I have recorded 24 hours of the Passion of Isa. And this is a spiritual mountain filled with food. Who will come and feed the master's household meat and food while the master is away? Isa said in Matthew 24:45. And know this, people, that Allah had no sons. I guarantee you. And also Mercury, as many pieces as you split Mercury into, it does not change. Mercury is Mercury, and Allah had no sons. Now, was Isa the Son of God? Hell yeah, because that's His name. But was He technically a Son of God? No. And Muhammad kept the mystery, and he knew that the Lord God Almighty has and always will be the best deceiver. It says that in the Quran many times. To hide something in plain sight. You see, what happened 2,000 years ago, early Christians caused the great distortion that Muhammad said would be gone in the end days. And I'm going to read you something very special for Islam. Islam, you have, there's a story by Cahil Gibran. There's a Muslim little froggy and a Jewish little froggy and a Christian little froggy. And they're all sitting on this log, you see. And within a moment of a moment, it came about that there was the movement, and the log that was right on the edge of the water, it started going. And these guys, these frogs, were sailing down, these three little frogs. Now, there was a fourth frog, but he saw wisdom in everything. He figured truth is truth wherever it is. So this other guy, he wasn't religious, kind of like me. And so what happened, all of a sudden the first little frog, he says, "Hey, this is the best log I ever did see. We're going zooming down. We're sailing and it's so much fun. All give thanks for the log, the magic log that's given us a ride. The wind is full and the tide is with us." And then the fourth little froggy said, no, that's not right. And they ignored that guy. Then the next little froggy says, "No, it's not the log that's given us the thrill of our lifetime. It's the water. The water is moving the log." And so next thing you know, the other froggy after the fourth one said, "No, no, 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 no." The third little religious frog, he says, no, you guys are wrong. It's our thoughts. That's where our thrill is. That's where the ride arrives is. The other stuff is, you know, it's all in the mind. So the other frog, he said, nope. And then they all three kind of looked at him, and you know how they jump at you? They all kind of jumped at him. They didn't like this guy. He was off there saying, no. And guess what? Turned out, the fourth little frog, he says, you're all right, and you're all wrong. He says, it is the log that's giving the ride. It is the water, and it is your thoughts. You're all correct. And they hated that. And those three, they ran over and they threw that fourth little froggy right into the deepest part of the river so that the big fishes could come and eat them. And that's exactly what happened. They sacrificed that fourth one because he was right, but they didn't want to accept that. So guess what? Here we go. It's time for understanding of what Muhammad said. He said the same thing that Paul said in Hebrews 8, the obsolescence of faith. He said that in the end time, in the Hadith,
field testing,
there would come a point
new demands on your
in history
typically requires trade-offs
when God would make himself known and Allah would be made known. And by the way, Allah is now a new name inducted from the great white throne on high, and Allah is no longer a title. Thus saith the prophet, who is the messenger of Malachi 3:1. I am not an important prophet. I am only a messenger, as was Muhammad. But I know this. This is truth, is self-evident, that the Lord God of Islam is the true God. The God of Christianity, number one, have a false God because they do not have the God of the Bible, which was not corrupted, but their understandings were, because they stole all the Hebrew books and then they dared to say, we are Israel, and all the prophecy is for us, creating a great distortionality. Because in Jeremiah 31:1, in the latter days, God would give their covenant to Israel and all families of Israel. Jeremiah 31:1 says so, in the latter days. And they've been standing on that covenant for 2,000 years, a covenant that has never even been given until now. And further, they do not have the God of all mankind, Jeremiah 32:27. What it says there is, Allah says, I am the Lord God of all mankind. And when he said that, it meant the same thing as saying, I am the Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. They are mine, and I am theirs. I am the God of Ishmael. I am the God of Muhammad. I am the God of Isa. I am the God of the prophets. And all the prophets are the crescendo of their writing is now screaming. And the Holy Spirit, Gabriel, as you know, is coming forth as the most regal eagle of the eons, transforming from a fluttering white dove of love so that we can mount up on eagle's wings. And so the Christians clearly do not have the God of the Bible. They switched identities. The son of Esau, in the book of Numbers, I believe, the identity of the younger brother stole Esau's blessing by tricking their father. And the same thing happened with Christianity. We are Israel. No, they were never Israel. And guess what? Now Israel has inherited all mankind, Isaiah 54:3. So Israel has now been given a new name in the latter days. And Muhammad said, the day is coming when my people of the Quran, in the Hadith, he said this. Look, Google it. You can Google anything. He said, my people will belong to another that sounds like Islam because of a book proving God's mercy. Jeremiah 31, verse 33 to 35. The very sentence, verse, or surah that Muhammad foretold, bringing forth the obsolescence of all faith, as Hebrews says. Now all faith that is before the living word of love is going to blow away, and then the Quran will be no more. nothing more of the Quran except its outward form. But guess what? The Quran will always be exalted. It will never be as Islamics believe, thinking it will be no more. That is absolutely not true. It will always be, I assure you, but it will never be important anymore, because the book proving God's mercy has indeed come, the book of love. And for our Lord God says unto all people, so that the shattering of the power of arrogant holy people as the Christians can be shattered, Daniel 12:7, because God's word was only closed until the time of the end, Daniel 12:9, because the message that prepares Allah's way and the arrival of Isa as the word of God unto mankind, that message is truly, truly, verily, verily, I say unto you, Muhammad said, and then all distortionalities would be removed, and he who would be his predecessor, or his successor rather, would be take every religion back to their own roots of their religion, because all the religions have strayed. Islam not as much, but praise God, Christianity has proven in this day to have a false god. But they teach that Jesus, Isa, Yeshua, Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. But they forgot that he said in John 10 that he is the good shepherd of all the flocks of Aaron, every single one of us. And so truly, truly, the arms of Allah are not too short to be unable to save. And furthermore, Christians have a false god who is a respecter of men, loves them best. God has always loved each and every one of us equally, and God never hated us at all, as people erroneously think. Even when all the ites were killing all the ites, and he said, fight like a demon and leave nobody alive, he only did that because at that point he was looking forward, and he saw the people of Israel could never even survive, much less Isa could never come through Mary. And so it was kill or be killed in the immature mentality that was necessary for the law and the best deceiver of them all to give his kingdom age new covenant of Jeremiah 31, of Jeremiah 1:10 and Haggai 2:2 that said Allah would tear down all distortionalities in the end. And the distortionality is the veil that has covered all nations, as Isaiah 25 says, and removing it so that no more shall any of us look through a glass darkly, but we will be able to see with the eye of our heart. And so in this hour, it is absolutely time to get with the utter truth of truth. And so it's time to realize that it's a time for living waters to come forth. Even the living waters from the sapphire sea on high, the crystalline bottomless blue ocean of the Lord's adoration. For his mercy shall certainly live forever and be forever. For he is the majesty of majesties. And in this hour, not only does Christianity have a false god that is a respecter of men, that loves them best, that is a sin according to the word of God, the Bible. And God has preserved that remembrance as well, the important, crucial parts. But people, not only that, they have a god that is a god of conditional love. If you do not believe he is love, even if you're a loving person, even if you obey what Isa said, as far as born again, you can't even say. It's like the wind. You don't even know where it's blowing, he told Nicodemus. And he says, but you must be as a little child, for surely, unless you become as a little child again with your love alive, as even if it's the size of the grain of wheat, a mustard seed even, you will have him living in you. Every knee will bow at the name of love. Not Jesus. Jesus was just a false, distortional name that was given to a false distortion of God, who was a respecter of men, who liked them best, who has been the false god over a bunch of identity stealers, is what it boils down to. But in the latter days, God has given Israel and all mankind the blessing. And he's saying to every single Islamic, proving God's mercy on you, he says, I am your God, you are my people, I forgive you, and I will never remember it again. I will write my law and my love upon your hearts. Beyond that, none will ever even need to be taught of me, saith the Lord God Almighty. For every single Islamic and every single Christian and every single agnostic, every single person in the world, when they were a child, they've all had unconditional love. Love is Christ's secret name of Mark 4. That is the name to which every knee will bow, every tongue will confess love, whom Christ is. And Isa, Yeshua, Jesus, whatever you call him, don't call him late for dinner because he's going to come and have some. But the Muslim people are right. So everyone needs to especially leave Christianity, where their own perceived Prince of Peace has no peace for the world. It is the antagonist of the nations, because they're pointing, judge not that ye be not judged, Christianity. The Lord himself is cutting off all your fingers according to his own word. Now is the time for the shattering of the power of the holy people, because his word was only closed till the time of the end, Daniel 12:9, because his message, unadulterated to all people, to all tribes, must be now, so that he can pour out his spirit of love upon all flesh, as Joel 2 and Acts 2 says, for those who love are born of God and know God, because God is love. But not one Christian in the world believes that verse, 1 John 4:7. That is where the name love is in the Bible, capital L, as John the Beloved, the Apostle, named Christ. So that name predates the name of Jesus, the false name of the false Messiah. And the false prophet of this world is preaching the same broken Jesus that has always been preached. I preach the restoration. And unless the restoration of Elijah happens, Acts 3:21 says, Isa is kept in reserve in heaven, and he cannot even return people. So it's time for this message to get out. Let the Lord light the candle of hope. Let him light the torch of the true God, Allah, because that is now his name according to him. And I can agree to disagree with anyone, but I am the judge over Christianity, and it must fall. Because the truth is, they've got truths, and they've been right about lots, and so has Islam, but you've all been wrong about a little. And so in this hour, Muhammad said that when the book comes proving God's mercy upon us, that then the distortionalities would go, and then there would be no more left of the Quran. Same fate as Hebrews 8 says for the Bible, because there is no good man, not even one, and we are angels in the flesh or demon wannabe. It's simply our choice. So here we go. Let's put a light of glory on this whole subject. Before I continue briefly, who am I? I am known as Shiloh in Genesis 49:12, one who has eyes red of THC and dull of wine. I am the one of Habakkuk's vision. Even though my soul is not upright, the just will live by my faith, even though my soul has been transgressed by wine. Because I hold the scepter of all authority, and I tell you the Quran is utterly true, and the Bible's interpretation, while it is utterly true, has been made opposite of true, totally. The true Isa would never be allowed to preach in any church, and this is evident. I am one writer, line by line, precept by precept, with the strong and mighty one come forth as a destroying storm, even as a hailstorm, to pull down distortionalities, like Muhammad said. Isaiah 28. I'm the writer of Habakkuk. This vision was written plainly on the tablet, so all those hearing it might run. It's written. I am the writer foretold in Deuteronomy 18:18, Shiloh, one whose eyes are red. And I'm the alcoholic of Zechariah 3, who was picked, even though barf was all over myself and my heart had no star at all. I hated the Quran, and I hated all people. Everybody was going to hell in my heart. And so I was the biggest Pharisee of Pharisees, the viper of vipers. And I guarantee you, no Christian, including David Wood, has a prayer of a chance. Man, I attacked that guy at Halloween. And I did it as, I must have seemed like a madman to him. I was yelling at that friggin' guy at the top of my lungs. So you Islamics, you want a match against someone who will win, hands down, a David against a Goliath? David Wood has absolute, I challenge the gutless guy who is a coward to debate with me. I am the father of Chrislam, and Muhammad is a true prophet, was, always will be. And the Lord Isa, Yeshua, Jesus, he has always been the good shepherd over all the flocks of men. And so in this hour, I am the alcoholic writer, the writer that was foretold to bring forth the everlasting gospel, the new gospel of creation. It is written in Revelation 14, but the Christians won't even believe their own book. You could Google it, Everlasting Gospel by me. It sounds just like Moses, I guarantee you. In the beginning was the light, though. It wasn't in the beginning, was the darkness. It's opposite. And it's self-evident that I am truly true there too, because the truth is Adam and Eve had no belly button. And the moment that Abraham had the knife over his son, within that moment of a moment, it committed Emmanuel into coming forth. Because within that moment, as Abraham stood there poised, ready to strike his own son, it only could have proved that God had did not love man enough to be able to do what Abraham was willing to do for him, if he did not offer to do the same thing, whether people want to believe it or not. And it's irrelevant. Anything about Jesus's divinity is irrelevant, because we are divine. All of creation has been groaning with great expectation for the revelation of who the hell we are. And the reason I know, it is written in Isaiah 45 of things to come concerning the future of my sons and daughters and the work of my hands. Command ye me, thus saith the Lord God, who has preserved the remembrances of prophecy to reveal a kingdom age where Islam takes the lead. For the Lord's glory shall cover the earth as waters cover the sea, as grass cover the land, as sands cover the most desolate of deserts, as beautiful buildings cover Dubois, and as the glory of the Quran will now be seen as a heart behind the star, and the fireworks of his love that will shine infinitely into the darkness. For over our star of stars, who is the true star of Bethlehem. And so in this hour, people need to agree to disagree with me on the minor points. But on the major point, God is now proven, peace be upon Muhammad, exactly what he has said in the Hadith. And so, but the Quran will not disappear. Something will come and take the Quran one night, Islam is taught, and not one ayah will be left. That is not true. Either in the heart of one person, but it will be taken away. It's, in a sense, it's true, but I guarantee you it is not true, because it's a metaphoric. The message of God's mercy is just a continuation in the Quran, the beneficent and the magnificence of his beneficence. So once you have a full realization of that, of his mercy, then the Quran is not important. But I guarantee you the Quran is not going anywhere. If anything, it will be exalted much more by the time I get done with it, because I've recorded all the all the exalted names of Allah. Just Google or go to YouTube under my channel, because I don't have an index, or I don't even know how to do all that stuff. Put into YouTube Islamic Dove of Love, Islamic Dove of Peace. I got lots of Islamic doves praising Allah, who is the true God, who is not a God who is a respecter of persons, who is the God of all mankind, everyone submitted to love. Jesus said, insofar as salvation goes, we must be as a little child with our love alive as a verb. So I tell people, get out of the land of the walking dead, where your love has become a byword, just as a noun, making your faith totally dead as well. And so it is urgent and important to realize that born again was never here. Many are going to say, Lord, Lord. He's going to say, I don't even know you. Get away from me. Because Christ and God, Allah, whatever you want to call him, I don't give a flying flip what you call him. Don't call him late for dinner. He's our majesty of majesties, our carpenter of the ages. He is all in all. He is love. That is his secret name. And so in this hour, it is written that indeed the Quran will be taken away by night at the end of time. And it will, for the importance, but I guarantee you, with full reverence, even Christians down the road under the kingdom age, which shall now begin. First, you have to have the knowledge in order to begin a new age. So they will even esteem, finally, the Quran, because Muhammad is a brother of another mother, and my name is Daniel. I am your Mahdi. And so it is written that you need to recite the Quran much before it is taken away. But rest assured that even the mark of the beast, the 666 on the head, is foretold to be defeated by Revelation 9:4, the mark of the Lamb, 777, upon every person of love, regardless of what they do or do not believe, has never been important, lest any man boast. It's not been about what we believe, it's what the Lord, who is our living mercy, decrees for us. And then many people will forget, and this will not happen either. And the word will be fulfilled against them, refers to the beast, and who was foretold to come. But a lot of things, like Dajjal, the beast, there are different, the false one doing miracles. He is the false Elijah, Dr. David Auer of Repent and Prepare the Way, a YouTube channel. And you can watch his video of him calling down fire from heaven, just as Revelation 13 said of the false Antichrist spirit, who is teaching the broken Jesus, who was never a true God at all. And there is only one Lord God, Elohim, Adonai, Allah. Isa, Yeshua, Jesus is one with God, and we can be one with our Lord too if we will just have love as a child. So there are three things which will not benefit anyone to believe if they did not believe before. They are the Dajjal, the beast, and the rising of the sun from the west, or the place from where it sets. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the messenger from Canada, from the north, of Isaiah 41, I have come, and the sun of righteousness has now risen in the west, as Micah 4 has foretold. For our Lord, by his spirit of love, is coming forth in this hour to raise Islam up to a higher place. For I am the judge, and it is foretold that the judge, will be judged, and Christianity shall now fall hard because they've had their fingers out far too long. But the good news is the peace that our Prince of Peace will bring will go before him, and that people will walk with their God and others with their God, how they conceive him to be, but it will be in peace, as Micah 4 says. And in these latter days, it is vital to realize what is ahead of us. And for that reason, I am so excited to be bringing you this message. And so I will be back in just a few minutes. And love from Canada. And know that as the one foretold to be a successor for Muhammad, know that I invite people to start communicating with me, leaving me comments. And may Allah richly bless you. And may the exaltation of the blessed, exalted names of Allah evermore be praised. So make sure you listen to them. I got hours and hours of it here at this channel. I will be back in one moment. And oh, I almost forgot to tell you. Metaphorically, it is impossible for the sun to actually set in the west. But because I am from Canada, the sun of righteousness has risen from the west. And I send back the same light that Muhammad sent the west from the east. And it is blinding because the Allah that I describe is the treasure of excellence, the excellence of treasure. He is the priceless pearl of great reward. He is our everlasting Father. He is the roaring lion of Zion. And he's roaring as loudly and softly as a little itty bitty kitties. Teeny weeniest little itty bitty purr, that it's not by power, nor by might, nor by understanding, but by love alone, that all things shall be accomplished, and peace shall be able to come into this world like a mighty whirlwind of blessedness, as he pours out his love upon absolutely all flesh, bowing to the great name of Allah.